City Lights is sponsored in part by McDonald's Family Restaurants. It's a great time for the great taste of McDonald's. And by your Philadelphia Coca-Cola bottlers. It's time for City Lights with Eleanor Jean Hendler.
There is evidence that the Japanese martial art of karate began as long as 3,000 years ago. Practiced now in almost every country on Earth, karate is still one of the world's most misunderstood art forms. Is it a spiritual art based on peace and on sacred Buddhist teachings? Or is it a lethal and undisciplined form of self-defense?
Hi, I'm Eleanor Jean Hendley, and tonight on City Lights, we'll explore the fascinating Japanese martial arts. Now, not long ago, students from the International Shotokan Karate Federation joined us right here in our studio for a demonstration and an explanation of this ancient way of life.
Saw are what are referred to in Japanese karate as kihon, or basic techniques. Karate is built and based upon those basic techniques that you saw, and you'll see an application of some of those techniques later on. But fundamentally, karate is based on a series of strikes, kicks, or punches. You saw me, the attacker, go against Mr. Okazaki. Master Okazaki defended using the strikes, kicks, and punches, the fundamental techniques of karate. You also notice that Mr. Okazaki applied another basic tenet of karate, and that is that a karate practitioner never attacks first. He always begins with a block, or begins with a defensive movement. So he always blocked after I attacked first, and then he delivered a strike, a kick, or a punch.
Master Okazaki, I was particularly impressed with the tremendous amount of self-control it must take to make sure that you don't harm your opponent when you're going through those basic techniques.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Karate, you know, about 2 to 3 years to develop that kind of a movement physically and mentally. That's why for our standard, it takes time, like, you know, 2 to 3 years.
Thank you.
Why did karate develop? What was the purpose for the art?
Well, that's like just you saw in the demonstrations. You discipline yourself and control yourself. And the final goal is there, we saying always, seek perfection of our characters. Go through to those training.
Now talk about discipline, Bruce. I know you've said in the past that that's one of the reasons why you continue to study, continue to practice. How does that translate into the working world for you and into your everyday life?
Well, fundamentally, the only way to learn karate is to do it. To do it repeatedly, over and over, complete dedication to the fundamentals that you saw in the Kihon demonstration. There's no quick way to do it. But through constant application, you become better and better and better. I apply that in my work life. Once when I made first degree black belt, Mr. Okazaki sat down with me and explained that people in the West sometimes believe that once they've become a black belt, they're an expert and there's no other reason to practice. He explained to me that black belt simply means that now you know what you don't know. And you apply that then to everything in your martial arts training, and if you apply that to your working life, then that provides discipline.
Sun's rising, biscuits are baking, birds are singing.
Like mackerel.
Are you single and looking for that special person? Find out how next week on our show for single men and women only.
Now, Chuck, it's time to spin the big prize wheel. You're going online now, kiddies.
Kata is a defense against numerous opponents, 3 to 4 opponents. And it is a simulation of what you would do if attacked by a number of opponents.
Determine whether you are actually learning the correct type of karate, because there are, as you are well aware, a number of schools and organizations who claim to teach the art.
Yes, we are belong to the affiliated in the Japan Karate Association, so only sanctioned by Japanese government. That's actually first check. They are sending a certificate. You can step in a club. Some place they have, that's like a real legitimate organization or club. Then secondary, you have to check how much discipline they have in the club's so-called atmosphere.
What you just saw was a fundamental self-defense technique. We had an attacker, a mugger, approaching a woman who was somewhat unprepared for the attack, but understood a basic self-defense technique. The basic self-defense technique involved her first breaking the opponent's concentration by stomping on his foot. When his concentration was refocused on his foot and away from her for a second, she took other movements to break the hold. This may look complicated to people watching, but if you keep your wits about you and use the element of surprise, you can apply basic self-defense techniques.
You've been watching Japanese martial arts with students from the International Shotokan Karate Federation in Philadelphia. And don't go away, because we'll be right back after these messages.